Welcome to MSI Cooldown. After day three of groups, I'm Dracos. These are the boys, Raz.
Yeah! Let's go. You're getting over here!
Are we meeting in the middle?
Yes!
I thought Raz was like, Raz, are you just like gonna keep it a foot away from Kobe? You're like, Kobe, no, you have to come to me.
Clean execution!
Looking, all right, it's our first day together. We're working on it. Of course, we did just come off of a yet another IG game, I think is what we can call it, where there are brief glimmers of hope. You think maybe, ooh, Fongwu Buffalo, they're showing us a lot of things, but then IG do IG things and absolutely take over. Of course, when we look back at the series, I think right now it feels like IG are just in a position of absolute dominance.
It's real fun to track this team because it always really stems in the 2v2 on the top side of the map. This time around, counter gank comes through from Ning, is able to just, I suppose, clop all over them.
Like, clop? Yeah.
Yeah, that works. That's a good adjective. I mean, overall, I just enjoy watching this team play. Consistently, Ning always hovers towards the top side of the map. He has the highest jungle proximity of, you know, in the tournament, I suppose, in the top lane. So he understands the Shy is the one you want to get ahead.
And I like how, you know, they're fully embracing it. They talk about themselves, how they try and have these happy games. And Ning, in his interview, was talking about, yeah, I'll pick the Kane. I'll pick, you know, Hecarim, all these types of champions to spice it up a little. I do think he was kind of underselling himself when he went as far as saying that the team would win even with a dog in his place, because he's actually been such an incredible jungler for them. You talk about him on the top side. This game, he absolutely dominated on the Hecarim.
I've always had those questions, like, since he joined Invictus Gaming, of how much of an impact does he have when he's literally, like, adjacent to the best solo laners in the world. And his consistency of being able to have the pressure, to be able to aid them. Once they have these advantages, they are the fastest team in the LPL, certainly in the tournament after what happened last night.
Yeah. Hard to contest that one.
There we go. And a lot of it is based off of his willingness to be able to pick up fights when they're able to keep rolling.
Well, regardless of his overall level, he will be the MasterCard player of the game. I think no surprises. He had huge kill partition, was a part of everything that was happening on the map. And now it leads us to this question. With Ning stepping up, you got Jakula performing well, the only other question mark I've ever had for this roster. Is IG the most dominant team that we have ever seen internationally?
Look, me and Dash have made it fairly clear. Like, I personally think this is the first time we'll ever see a 10-0 tournament, in the sense that Invictus Gaming have come up and shown so strong. They themselves are their own worst enemies for them. Like, like, they come into the Fongwu Buffalo game. I'm not talking about this one because Meliodas played very well. I'm going to give them that respect. That's why they're competing in this game. But the first time around, and then the Flash Wolves game, the happy games we're referring to, they themselves are not taking this as seriously when they're going up against, like, the teams that are expected to drop out of groups so they can drop it.
Does that itself, the fact that they, you know, try and have these, we keep having this term, but for lack of a better word, happy games.
I want the person out there who has no idea what we're talking about, like, where did this come from?
But does that itself preclude this team from being, you know, the most dominant or whatever? Because I do remember the Samsung White just completely suffocating. You know, the Vision game was completely different back then. So you could actually have this feeling of there is nowhere for you to go on the map where you can actually have an impact. Like, in that stage of League of Legends, I remember that feeling of, like, it was inevitable, the victory for Samsung, right? Or even a couple of years of SKT you can draw back on. But honestly, I think that this IG team is the most talented team that we have ever had. I don't know about the most dominant part.
Because dominant, there's multiple metrics. Your point the point you're talking about is, like, strategically impossible to deal with, like, Samsung in the past or SKT in the past.
And I think to a certain degree, when you open yourself up to a skirmish-heavy playstyle, people are going to die in the process. And despite the fact that you win every skirmish, when you walk out, your scoreboard still has, you know, three or four deaths on it.
But does that feeling when you go up against Invictus Gaming, and Fugbu Buffalo have definitely felt that, is, like, no matter how large of a lead that you have, you go into these fights. That Flash Rolls game we had earlier today, I was like, how did they win, like, or at least get a positive trade? This was before the Baron was even a thing. Where Invictus Gaming get a 2-for-1 when they are that far behind. And ultimately, it's because Ning, the Shy, and Rookie are just that talented. If you fight them into Fog of War, if you don't have the information necessary, they're going to come out ahead.
The part I like is that because of IG's style and because they are not afraid to die to make things happen, there is at least still hope for the enemies, right? You have these moments, you know, whether it should be real or not, whether that's founded, of like, heck yeah, we can defeat the world champions. And so, I don't know, that sort of life to me makes the games more exciting, but also Kind of makes me side with a couple of the older teams.
Yeah, and also makes me scared for the future. I feel like until either for us, Kobe, NA or EU are like actually hitting the nexus, we'll be like, it's just a happy game, it's just a happy game, it's just a happy game. Like, cannot believe it.
The fun fact for everybody out there is when you look to the SKT in the past, or even like for chance the Samsung in the past, you're like, you know, there's the one old player, Heart from Blues, an older player. You look at this team and it's like, all of a good portion of them under 20. I'm like, oh, they can destroy that team if they themselves choose to leave. But ultimately, this team can sail on for like a good amount of time, 5 years from now.
Yeah, mm-hmm. The question feels like more right now. It's not are they the best, it's how long will they remain the best.
There
it feels
go.
Like the bigger question for IG. Well, with four teams left for each team, or four games left for each team, IG is still undefeated in first place, followed by G2 and SKT. Now, when we look at the standings, there's also this close fight going on between Team Liquid and the Flash Wolves for the last semifinals berth, with PvP just one win behind. And I think when you look at it, battle for fourth place. I didn't think it was going to be a thing, but it is a thing. After today, it is very close. In this
honestly, place. Today had me a wee bit sad, fellas. I was really sweating because the Team Liquid game versus Flash Wolves today, we had that Ryze left open, right? So then they felt like they had to pick up the Ryze, the super powerful flex pick that all the other teams have been able to use very successfully. But you get a little bit worried because that has not been the style that Team Liquid have won with, yet they draft it. And that with a LeBlanc means that they won't have their usual fallback pattern of waiting towards the mid game and being able to win those team fights. Then they still force team fights later in the game. Around Rift Herald is one of the big areas where they forced it, and then Flash Wolves take control of the game. All of a sudden, they're kind of on the other side of the table where Team Liquid are facing down a better team fighting team, and they aren't able to make use of the tools that they did draft, trying to 1-3-1 and look for more individual outplays and use a killer instinct to try and make some more individual big plays. And Flash Wolves come away with a well-earned victory, which makes me so scared for Team Liquid, and kind of that fourth spot is definitely up for grabs.
And it's justifiable, right? When we come into this tournament, we expected fifth and sixth was the fight for Fongvu Buffalo and Flash Wolves, not moving up into fourth. Team Liquid, we thought, yeah, maybe they're a little bit below the top three, but they should be close. I'm curious, something I've heard a lot today is that Team Liquid, if they don't have double lift set up to carry, they cannot win a game. Do you think
because
that's fair?
My point on this one is I think that a lot of it is that they put too much pressure on themselves internally. Like, that's what it feels like every single time a Team Liquid comes into international events. Like, the aftershock point that we either make, or Smithy, like, just the small mechanical errors that we see that's very uncharacteristic of the team. And, of course, they're changing their styles because it almost feels like, to your point, that this is the one way they can win, when they have multiple carries like Jensen and Impact have been balling this tournament. So we'll have to see, and hopefully the team can refocus going into the next few games in the tournament.
Now on the opposite side, Flash Wolves, this is a team that maybe not as happily for you because they're looking very good now, Cody, yeah. But on the back of Team Liquid, this is a team that has risen up. Team fighting proficiency was something that we knew that they had in their back pocket, but this feels like the first day where we've really seen it come alive.
And I'm just honing in on Boogie. Because for the entire tournament, we've been criticizing him and trying to get more action out of him, more proactivity, and him just nailing onto the Xin Zhao and really allowing Rather and Betty to be the carries, creating a lot of space for him. Because if you're watching the earlier games, or at least like day one, day two, it's like, well, Betty's face-to-face with an assassin in these team fights. Like, what is the positioning when this team is so well known for team fighting? I can't tell because, well, you're leaving your AD carry to dry. And Rather hasn't been performing in the first few days. And this today, at the very least, he was hitting it hard, or at least yesterday when his game when he went up against G2. So it's nice to see the carry starting to perform. It's nice to see the facilitators actually putting out the pressure.
Yeah, I really like that you start with Boogie, because junglers at this tournament have been incredibly important. So it was essential for Flash Wolves that Boogie stepped up today with the Xin Zhao back-to-back picks. It really just changed the face of this team. They're able to get to that team fighting phase, and pull out these victories. So it's definitely looking like a good race there for our fourth place.
Definitely the case. Well, we continue the second round robin tomorrow, starting with G2 versus Flash Wolves. Of course, the Western teams will get a chance to prove themselves against IG as the LPL champions look to go 8-0 before the last day. But I've got my eyes on all the Liquid games and all the Flash Wolves games right now.
Honestly, same. even more than usual here. Like, it's just, I'm on the edge of my seat because I was really holding on a lot of hope until the games today, and this is the first day that really kind of shook me.
What do you think it was about today, Kobe? Before we sign off for the evening, what do you think it was about? I want to hear this, right? Because I think you have been the diehard. You've never doubted them, and uh-huh. This is the first time I've ever heard you doubt. I feel like an NA team.
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely the way that they lost, where, you know, them drafting into this style, I was like, okay, you know what? They must have practiced this, and they're looking at executing around the strong champions that they have drafted. And then for them not to be able to do that, and them, as soon as they start, honestly, that Rift Herald, when they started that up, and Flash Wolves had all teleports ready, and they join, and then they fight the 5-on-5 at this, like, early stage where they have the possibility of using some of the best split pushers in the game and going for picks. It definitely worried me.
It hurt. All right. Well, thank you for the very personal insight there. Well, thank you, Kobe. Thank you, Raz. So for myself, the casters, and the entire broadcast crew, thank you for watching. We'll see you tomorrow for more of MSI 2019. Good night.
It's up to you to prove to us now that you are the Korea of old. If you're gonna ramp up, this is the time.
That's not gonna be the ulti over the wall. Corey today gonna be trying to be brought over, but nice flash kick gets Jensen out as well. It should be 3 unanswered kills. Mata dead makes it a second kill for Team Liquid, but Faker could find his own second. Gets a third thanks to Clint, and they're just cleaning up now. That's the ace, and SKT 3-2 to end the first round robin. Double is now gonna be in some trouble. 4-man lockdown from the mid laner. It's a double kill over to Betty, and the Flash Wolves will rend Team Liquid asunder. IG on the road for that one.
Oh, baby freak.
Flash Wolves find themselves a fight against the Shy, who jumped right into some of his own demise. Is there more CC? The Flash Cannon, and they get it.
The Shy, meanwhile, on Cannon, does have teleport, and they're using the rope up right into the Baron.
I'm not even sure that was spotted. Baron for Invictus Gaming, and here comes the team fight. They picked up one kill already. As the Akali jumps in for a kill. Another for Jackie Love, already onto a triple. He's slaughtering Flash Wolves. He finds the Quadra. Jackie Love pulls back the feathers. He's going on a killing spree. Valon's down to about 100 HP. Meliodas going to be taken down. They will remain undefeated today. Wonder closes in. Over the wall he goes, looking to maybe grab himself a bone skewer. 9-9-9-9. That's some damage on the enemy jungler. Make it 2. Baker makes his way into the fight now. Khan going to be thrown up into the air. Redemption coming down. It's a double kill over to Wonder immediately. 7-0. Here comes the next one. The knock of his in. Shen is delivered. A double kill for the Rek'Sai. One more shot would kill him. Waits for the shield out. Let's go
down.
Both comes up, and he's got the damage. A solo kill on the top laner. Majichi now forced to once again walk away. Millions leading the charge into Hasgard and Angel finds him. Knock up in comes Victoria trying to duel against Wonder. Big damage to those health bars, and the red team is dropping. That is it. Bungu Buffalo will not go winless. They will knock down G2.